be a crab or junior my channel, so I wish for me that's when I'm in our OTA. I had a money in the same, a year, Jacqueline Ama Pokuaa, and then a bush and four, and then I saw four new workers phone in a morning, a junior, and then a more janet chick, quiet crab, a bush and phone in our trance, and I might say, I'm the moon, a big coffee, on the back of Ghana, a crack could see, and see what has he ever cover. Never woman who near my air corso, any BBA, so on to ya. About 3 weeks ago, and a gun and a social worker, a friend of my Pokuaa or Kwe Juma or no crampo de and Tia Metene say, I owe Juma night and I do. We be friend and say, Nejuma any back of friend and say, O may a Juma and Mano said the old Akumapa and the boo be out your bad time that you be honest be more intino or your penny or quacko, ye a Juma Ama, Nipa or calling in a Jumano and a Fufi and Tuata. A Hernandez, Mexico ni Abemu Bia or Ko jail or free jail by. Or ban or tete, I can't you are on any girlfriend on him. Ah, wow, and oh, yes, okay. So, I would be a maiden, no question. But to Ocon, and also, I found one dream born. I found hope out the two a shannon one who be any crampo say it to a shannon and a coy into coy and who say, ah, I'm part the metiano say I'm passing wow. Now, make corner not on him, and then as you see, I want him out wow, Marcia Bay, which means a crown and your media. And when did you create our mommy? What for me cheap and you know the cocoa pie on Tiasia or yes giddy giddy and oh you two yes obi or baby will be a obi shooting because I have not been born a bunny trim and I only have a Jackie as I say or akuma pa baby or be a sumji any odo ama nini enti no ti dede no oye se oye de oko na wako akusisi o montel na odi ye atu ye eno nso oko ya nipaboni eye Hernandez e shutu na oku na nyo nonko o shutu ada nesa ono nso wo delivery room ho ono nso ye Annette Flowers ono nso ono do America he ya enti no eho e pupu ye na ye de bremu ye ko ho omo ye eyi no bibia no de besi bia no mema maso ate se bibi ni na se wote en kaibo yin so a ye nua ba no oja ba eye baako boy baako 12 year old boy e wo asasi so enti sa wo ba yi na na so wa bo a ho na wa ba ba bo a
mpanifo bu web se so twan kwa ne ho makọ se bibi mpo ni na se adjuma ana yare ama akwa na se wenti mi amba eye bi mpo a at least omo numbers on their to join e cash up and as well with me bibi dia bo busia no a number on their to join e 9172611212 Mr. Ngosubio 9172611212 number on the Atidana, a cash up and a zell. A mubiano, which me are sending, dear, that's a Kevin Boos, Kevin Boos, but who send it, inquire. A young almost over soon from my friend, no matter what I say. A moment to me and from crime, the zone, you may walk my film now, the abuano, on also a day, a bit shall no abuano, a bit me ato, a bit me ato, and uncle da, and other. Said the abobo, a more community moon in an, also meaning you've been FM, what a busiano.
We are any year, Mao. This world no, you never know. Until no moment under royal, then show do. You may call inside. They are costing you na. You are the bedroom. Maybe until me chat videos ni na because the family reserve the right of some of the videos ni until no. Ah, you be keep it no for the family no. Na ya mama san so who the air cost ni bibia eh. Until no time to school. Junior me channel ni the air cost of Dallas bia. You are the bedroom now so what na no ahead the air cost. You keep informed. Me try ya ho. You are busy here.
I am the only one. sebe. Oh, hey, oh, hey, oh, be a yenne. Yeah, oh, asem mefi, asem sebe.
Bra bomu atoda bia wo yam show eh na wa komo atu wo te yasem no ani so bra na wo su asminia nya bo tre mesra wo ashaden e wo se popo bi wa ya no ho fro ya fro e dia bi so wo ha tintim utu a entu ampa enye se bia chiabo ebu enye se bia fe no bo minia na emom waduru wa ma me kai kai lazros na mani hunu hwedi ampon chamede ma komo munyedu enti hwan kura eno be hye me funu mu kwabi wo wo die wonia bo eh abomi mu abobi ade ehuna huna me asanso abomi hu ugina chen a bia wonti ase ebe ye wabufu wo be kase hwan kura na wawu ama kwabena bo mi su wo be kase hwan kura na wawu ama me ti aboboy okay te waso din ma me hye omu ma me kan kire wo eje me nua bae bia na yonkofa eh na edi mu eye me nua bae bia me ne no edidi bo mu enti wati se mi su a mini ya mesere wa subi bua me what to say me kemu a eje kemu bua me asemu e ya se ah it mean to us
dinya me cha no ya da mo se mu zuti e be bia me wo e crossroad ama pokuaa Jacqueline said me dikan ka chere mo no e ho na e wo e ohwe body ya da me chen a ne body e ne da ho no e busia fo ha ado fo ha ejuma fo ha channel media social media bibri fo ha se mu nya ba be cover ne nyina e di odo e ba be kra ye nya ba echi ye nyina ye ba be kra ye nya ba echi kra akoma pa ne odo pa o wa de tena wi ase no e no na ma nkofo bibri aba ha mo wede mo so ba be bua we nyina no mo so e kra ne chi kra afina nkofo gusu ba ohwe me chi a nkofo hye da amba enwie ohwe me chi a bodo no ene da ho no aha se afina nkofo gusu ba omo fele ba nkofo mba wi a ngusu e ba adofo gusu ba bodi no e wa ha se a omo ba be start procession no aha se dem di ka ka chere mo ye di di bitimi di abrɛ mo ba the family reserve the right videos ni bi ntini ntimi fa ne nyina mbro ntini ye nu aba ama Jacqueline ama pokuaa ono oda ho no emre ba mu a ye di nyida ka nyina bebrɛ mo ye de busa fo ni bi be kasa me ye hwɛ ye wi nso a enwumre ye wi nso a enwumre om de ye ne be hwɛ hwɛ so o divine grace se o wo odo akoma pa bibia so so ba be bo busa fo no we divine grace e ho ne de ayi ni nyina aye de e be kwa kɔto aso family ni de e busa fo ate ase se om de be kɔ fie nto mu nsie wa o ba na wa hwɛ sapo mu de na so wa wi aboa na wa de aboa o ye a ene ye ma omo o mi nyina ne do ye ho di nyame cha na mi ntwa ho ye ba sisi a
blessings from the most high for me ni di nyame cha no kɔ fo ye ni kɔ mo ye de ba trust
saved a wretch like but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace my fears relieved.
You can be seated, please. Thank you. Good morning, and we're so glad you're here today as we honor Jackie's life. You know, the family wants to thank you so much for being here. Your prayers and your support mean so much to them. And I know they do now, but I know in the days ahead, they will need your support. Your phone calls, your texts, everything will be encouraged from this day forward. So just be around them, love them, support them, do the things you want to do with them, and they would appreciate that so, so much. I want to start out this morning quickly by just reading a poem, and this is how it goes. It says, "Life is just a stepping stone, a pause before we make it home. A simple place to rest and be until we reach eternity. Everyone has a life journey, a path to take, lots to see. The Lord guides our steps along the way, but we were never meant to stay. Our final destination is a place filled with love and joy in His majesty and grace. Today we celebrate the life of a loved one who has gone before us, the race she has won. Her journey is now ended, her spirit has ascended, claiming the great reward with Jesus, our Lord." You know, on occasion, God puts someone on this earth that impacts so many people. Always cheerful, always glorious, always amazing to be around. Jackie was a person who could change the atmosphere in a room when she was in there. She liked to joke, she liked to just laugh, and she had so much joy in her life. See, Jackie was a person just like that, and you couldn't help but feel good when you were around her. She was a faithful servant. She loved her family, faithful to her family, faithful to Christ, faithful to her church. And you know, who would have thought that on October 22nd, as she got up and got ready to go to work, that her life would change in such a dramatic way for her and her family? But, you know, we know that she is with the Lord today, and that's why we're celebrating her life. You know, there's many questions in this life. Why her? Why now? Why did Jackie leave us so soon? But James 4:14, this is what it says. "Yet you do not know what your life will be like tomorrow. You are just a vapor that appears for just a little while and then vanishes away." We know life is short. We know that we have celebrated the life of a loved one who has already gone before. But we know life is short. But, you know, for a Christian, I think one thing we need to think about, it's like a homecoming. It's like we're going home. And that's the way God meant it to be. So this morning, we're not here to say goodbye to Jackie. We're here to say see you later. Because we know that one day we will see her again. So Psalm 116, 15, David says, "Precious in the sight of the Lord are the death of His saints." And it's kind of hard to grasp just thinking about that. But when Christ sees His children come home, it brings joy to Him. When the great Christian in science, Sir Michael Faraday, was dying, some journalists questioned him about speculations about life. And this is what he said. He said, "Speculations? There's no speculations. I know nothing about speculations. I'm resting on certainties. And I know that my Redeemer liveth, and because He lives, I shall live also." You know, as we pass from this life into eternity, we are here for Christ. We are here to be representatives for here on this earth. And one of these days, we will be with Him, living with Him, face to face, arm to arm, love to love. And so that's why we celebrate Jackie's life today. Let's pray. Father, we love You. We thank You again for this holy day. We thank You for the day of celebrating Jackie's life. We are honored that we were a part of it just for a little while. But God, I just pray a special prayer for this family, that You would comfort them during this time. And Father, I pray that today would be a day of encouragement for them. And God, that we all know that we all point to you as our Savior, as our Comforter, as our Peacemaker. And Father, right now, be in the hearts of everyone here today with the comfort that we know that she is with you and she is loving you and you are loving her. And we are thankful for her life and the impact that she had on so, so many people. We love you and we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Right at this moment, we're going to have a family obituary. So we've got some people that are going to come up and speak about Jackie's life. So you guys come on up at this time.
Good morning. Thank you for showing up. This is Jacqueline Ama Pokuaa's biography. She was born on July 30th, 1977 in Asafo Kumasi to Colonel David Boache and Madame Cecilia Ejewa of Atonsu Okoko, both in Ashanti region of Ghana. She was the first child and daughter of Auntie Sisi, and her birth made Auntie Sisi very happy. She called her bundle of joy and would sneak in the name Joe, usually calling her Jackie Joe, to demonstrate her joy of having a daughter like Jackie. She lived up to her name, bringing joy. If you've ever seen Jackie, you know she's always smiling. She began her schooling at Queen Elizabeth Day Nursery in Asafo Kumasi. And she was one of the children that was transported to school by a well-named teacher, Teacher Kwame. She enrolled in school, and as a five-year-old chubby, pretty girl, she had a strong interest and enthusiasm for school extracurricular activities and was quickly the favorite of most teachers and classmates. She was intelligent. She was very good at many things, which was no surprise. And she pursued everything with great zeal. She became the face of the State Experimental Cultural Adwa Group, representing and leading guests and dignitaries all over. She then took her common entrance and passed and went to St. Monica's, where she was popular among many people and won admiration of many of her peers, seniors, and juniors. And she was known as Amalapi. Her friends always were a big part of her, and she had a great bond with many of them, some of who are here today. Thank you guys so much for being a good friend to Jackie. She then, in the lower six, was elected dining hall prefect, which was a big deal for her. She enjoyed hosting. If you know Jackie, she can host pretty well. She did pretty good, then passed her A-level exams and started the University of Science and Technology in Kumasi, doing bookkeeping. She was not satisfied with what she did, and so shortly afterwards, she enrolled at Winona State University to study social work, where she started in 1998. At Winona State in cold Minnesota country, she flourished. She did good there, and she had many interests. She was also a part of the African dance troupe and folklore, and many other things, including the YWCA camp in Ghana. And she earned an honors degree in social work at Winona State in 2001. After Winona State, she moved to Houston, where she spent several years doing social work, which was her passion, because her passion in life was people. She believed that if she could influence people's lives, that they would be better than what she had left them. So that's what she did. But after a little while, she left and returned to Ghana in 2009. And while in Ghana, she decided to start a company, an event planning company called Simply Elegant, because that is who she is. She is simply elegant. She was quickly famous for everything that she did, including being able to network, connect with people from any circle at all. She could actually turn your event into an amazing one. And so she was a one-stop shop for all. After a while, she knew that this was not fulfilling and this was not really why she was here on Earth for. So I remember she sold everything and decided to start over and pursue her love for social work. So she enrolled at UT Dallas for her master's with a major in mental health. She then began her full-time social work at Bedford and then eventually to Methodist Hospital, where she was the director of social work, where she did everything she could and did it with true passion and joy until the fateful day of October 22nd, 2020. A day that is indelibly marked, I'm sure, in everybody's heart that is present here today. So despite being single, she was a great and gifted advisor to many, even those who were married. And she was also very adept in giving business advice to many people. She was exceptional, she was creative, and she was literally extraordinary in everything she did. From hosting to just being kind and generous to family and friends. Again, she is simply elegant. And we are in shock, disbelief, and quite frankly, in awe that this is how her story ends. But as Pastor said, we rejoice in the fact that because of her faith, it is not her end, but it is her beginning. And so we are grateful that we got to be a part of her life, no matter how big or small. And we know that God will continue to bless and keep all of you. And if we have one request, it would be that you show up for people just like Jackie did. No matter where you are, no matter where you find yourself, show up. Go the extra mile, because that's what she did every single day of her life. Thank you, guys.
Oh,
Jacqueline Ama Pokuaa, my one and only. I have known Jackie since I got married to my husband. Everybody calls him Uncle Phil, Mr. Dad. Jackie has taken me as an auntie, a sister, a friend. Since I met Jackie, her beautiful smile, her good spirit has taught me a lot. My dear friend, she has been into my life, my family, and the whole community. Jackie has inspired me to be an amazing woman as I stand here. Despite I'm her auntie, her friend, her everything. She calls me Odoyo, my dear Nina. Jackie, thank you. I want to say thank you for all you have done for my children. All the children you have trained in this world, you loved what you do. Give your all. You have always gone extra miles. Uncle Phil will miss you forever. This beautiful soul here will cook every Saturday morning and bring it to her uncle, her father, her best friend. We have really, really, really missed a great person on earth. She was an angel on earth to us, to the community, and to the whole world. Nigel wants to say thank you. Jeffrey wants to say thank you. I'm not going to mention names, you know. They will never disappoint you, my dear darling. Rest with the angels, my dear. We will meet again. I love you. I cherish you. And I say thank you. May God bless you, sister.
This is tribute from St. Monica's Old Student Association in Texas. If you're a Mochi girl and you're here, would you please be on your feet while we read our tribute for Jacqueline? Mucha girls. He will wipe every tear from your eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. It means in heaven there will be no pain, no sorrow or death. All our grief will fall away, and we will feel God's unending love. On October 22nd this year, we received the terrible news that Jackie, our schoolmate, passed away while at work doing what she loved to do most, serving others. Death has taken away a genuinely warm person, more importantly, a loving mother and a sister, and deprived so many of a good friend. Jackie, you were ripped from this earth in a devastating act of violence that touched the hearts of millions. Jackie was a student of St. Monica Secondary School, also known as Mochi, from Form 1 to Upper 6. She was such a sweet and lovable person. loved by many students. Jackie was exceptional and a dear to a great number of students in our school. While at Moche, she held one of the important positions as a dining hall prefect from 1994 to 96. Jackie was brilliant, intelligent, and very resourceful. We were not surprised she chose the path of becoming a social worker. Jackie's exuberance was matched by her keen intellect and passion for all things at Munche. Jackie, as they say, once a Munche, always a Munche. You certainly made our school a better place. We all know that life isn't fair sometimes. It's not fair that Jackie was taken away from us at 45. It's not fair that Jackie couldn't live long enough to see her son graduate from school. And it's not fair that St. Monica's old school association, Texas, would have been without Jackie's contagious laugh. Things won't ever be the same. Our dear Jackie, we will miss you and your ever smiling face. May you rest in the Lord. Each for all and all for God.
Good morning to you all. Thank you for coming. I'm here to read a tribute from our father, Colonel Retired David Ansapwache. My soul is greatly troubled. I am weary with my mourning. Every night I flood my bed with tears. I drench my cup with my weeping. My eyes waste away because of grief. Psalm 6:3-7. The psalm captures my current state. Ama was known by all for her smile, her friendliness, her affable nature, how this smile would be mixed. Jacqueline Ama Pokuaa was the child of my youth. I had Ama when I completed the military academy and was undertaking my first young officer's course. Growing up, Jackie was with her mother in Kumasi while I moved from one garrison to the other. However, after 1988, she regularly came to Accra to be with her siblings because I had lost my wife, and she became a pillar of strength for me as she molded her siblings. Ama had a great influence on how my home was managed by becoming the madam of the house. I used to travel a lot during my professional career in the armed forces. Either on course within the country or beyond, or on UN peacekeeping operations, I never entertained any fear that in my absence anything would go amiss. Ama never gave me any cause to be afraid when I left money for the upkeep of the family. She became a beacon of hope as well as a trailblazer to her siblings. Because of Ama, I have lots of daughters. She will come home with friends from St. Monica's whenever school was on vacation. These young girls Ama brought home are now big women with families and are all spread all over the world. Ama made me the proud father of many daughters. Ama Jackie, can you answer me? Why did you insist on leaving for the USA in 2017. With deep love and emotions, I remember pleading with you not to go. My last words to you before you left was, "Dad, Ama, I don't think I'll ever see you again." I said that because I was getting older and falling sick quite often. So the logical conclusion was that I may depart this earth before you ever change your mind to relocate back to Ghana. Little did I know that the omnipotent God had plans for which I, mortal man, could not fathom. Ama Jackie, You've left a big vacuum and confusion in my life. Can I say that my life is shortened because of your death? Who will purchase and bring down my medication from the USA to Ghana every month? Will you be sharing jokes and serious ideas with from time to time? A lot of your sisters, schoolmates, want to abduct and bring up your 12-year-old son. Where do we, the parents, fit in this equation? When I received the news of Ama's untimely death on 22nd October 2022, I was beside myself in grief. Words are not enough to express my emotion and psychological state under the circumstances that had. Not being for the hand of the Almighty God, I am comforted by the words of Revelation 21 verse 4. Because one day soon, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes, there shall be no more death, no sorrow, no crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Ama, I love you and will always cherish your memory. You will always be in my heart because in there you are always alive. Today, Ama is no more longer here. But I look forward to the resurrection morning when the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and then the dead in Christ will rise first. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, 16 to 17. Until that morning, Ama, Jackie, Daye, rest in peace. Thank you.
Everybody, tributes by Mother Sisi. Please, can we stand and help us to sing this song?
Tribute to you, Jacqueline. This is very hard for me, ending. But as difficult as it is, I think about a lot of things and I believe that you deserve one from Mommy. So I'm writing one to you. I remember your words of advice to me when Mommy, your grandmother, passed away. You encouraged me to reflect on the good and positive times because our God liveth and we can face tomorrow. But you also admit that daughters are every mother's pride, and losing you is unbearable. So please, my princess, allow me to grieve. Allow me to cry and mourn for you, for there is no other way to scale through this piercing arrow of pain. We formed an unbreakable bond the moment you got into my life. The joy of your expectation and delivery grew alongside your tiny self within me. I recall your birth with great fondness. As I watched your pretty little face all I could see was myself, a soul that formed a bond that will last forever. Oh, how it was, how it all happened so quick that we didn't even have time to take inventory. From breastfeeding to watching you grow into a beautiful woman, this time has passed by too quickly. I just wanted this bond to last a little longer, this joy of mothering you. Ama, you have made me so proud of who you were and your accomplishments. Stretching beyond the stars to achieve your goals was something you were born with, and you did it with much ease, and lovingly you always won. Ye mi bruni, wudu huimhuimhuami. You have left this life far too soon, and I'm now left to mourn you, but what am I to do? We have priceless memories that have filled our hearts since the day you entered my life. With these memories, I will keep you close by in my heart forever, because this is a bond that not even death can take away. It breaks my heart to think that we will all turn back and leave you here alone. That breaks my heart. That silences me. But I am powerless. I am only trusting Christ, basing my hope solely on Christ and his righteousness. He has been my solid rock on which I stand since you departed shockingly. All other grounds appear to be sinking sand. This daughter I adored so much has been taken away from me forever. I will always think of you in silence so that no eye may see me weep, because many silent tears are shed when others are asleep. Ama, kafra awate, abaya die namisumi die. Sleep in heaven, my dear. Sleep with your maker. Rest well, Ama Jackie. Do not ask me if I'm okay. Do not ask me if I'm doing. Do not ask me if I'm okay. Don't say there is a better place, as you won't like what I say. No, time is not a healer, and this is not God's will. If he knew how much I've really lost, they would be right here still. I won't try to be positive, and this wasn't for the best. My heart is broken in pieces, and it hurts deep in my chest. Don't say, at least, they are out of pain. Well, I am not, and may never be. The pain is gone, but mine is still here. It's been passed on to me. Don't tell me you know how I feel, even though it may be true. This grief is mine. For what length of time it takes me to get through, allow me to grieve.
Mom, your sudden passing has been a big pain to me, but I'm consoled by the fact this was never your wish for us. You always wanted the best for us, the best for me, and I know I was your priority. Mom, thank you for bringing me into this world. Thank you for giving me the freedom and space to grow. You always encouraged me and assured me of your love. You built in me so much confidence, and you always told me to do what makes you happy. Mom, I realized that although you taught me so much, there's one important thing I didn't realize yet, and that's how I'm gonna be able to live, to cope with you without you in my life. I'm really missing you now, Mom. Mom, your memories are going to be my keepsakes. Anytime thoughts of you flashes or I remember something we did together or something you said, all I see is the light on my face. I find myself smiling, so I'm not going to let those tears mar the smiles that you have given me when you were here. The magnitude legacy you have left for me, I'm gonna live the rest of my life with her. I promise you I am going to live to your expectations for me. I only ask of you, Mom, to keep watching me from heaven, for I will be needing that always. Walk with me, keep me close by until the day we meet again. Rest well, Mom. Rest in heaven. Love you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Jackie was my big sister. I will first say thank you to Auntie Cici for what you did for Jackie. you love her so much. You gave her good education. You gave her whatever you had since she was a child. She will always appreciate what you did for her, bringing her to America, paying her tuition, with whatever you got when she was a kid. My sister and I had a great bond that a lot of people didn't know about. I loved her so much since childhood. She taught my family and I a lot of stuff that we didn't know. And she always tells me that together we are strong and we should keep it up as family. Words can't really explain what kind of feeling I have for my sister, but may her soul rest in peace, and I will always love her. Thank you.
It is what it is, right? Life happens, you know. I was still didn't expect to be up here to talk. I'm his brother from California. You always hear her say that, right? Yeah. And I'm sitting here, got nothing to say, but in this moment, if I don't come here and talk, then who else, right? Yeah. It's a brief life. It's a brief life. She just came to visit me just a couple of months ago. And I was a lot of siblings. If you really know her, I think if you just being honest with you, everybody knows I'm a friend of siblings.
Good afternoon. My name is Reverend Martin Osain. I am the pastor of the Ghanaian Community Presbyterian Church, and I speak on behalf of the Ghanaian community. I think there is a need for somebody to speak up about this close-knit community called the Ghanaian community here in the DFW Metroplex. We care and love each other under the umbrella of the Council of Ghanaian Associations and the many community organizations, the Ghana Nurses, the Ghana Professionals Network, the Ebe Association, the Ekwapiman, the Asantiman, the Gadangbe, and all the other groups that make up the Ghanaians here in the DFW Metroplex. What we have heard today about our sister, it is the DNA of every Ghanaian. the Ghanaian hospitality, the kindness, the generosity, the type of people we are, for those of you who are not Ghanaians here, we are a peace-loving people. So for one of us to fall out of violence was a deep cut in our hearts. Because wherever we are, and whatever we do, and in any walk of life we are in there to help and to make a difference. Just this morning, I drove a number of our young people to Plano to compete in a robotic competition, and they are there right now. I left them and came here. That is the community we are raising each other up, Mbutu. I am because you are. So, family, we share in your sorrow. This is a deep loss for the entire Ghanaian community here in the DFW Metroplex. And we cannot replace Jackie. But my friends, when you look at that picture, and you look at 1977, when Jackie was born, and the Lord called her home 2022, you see a little line behind those two dates, the dash. Everything we have heard here today about Jackie is her dash, the person she was, the difference she made, the impact she had. No wonder the Bible says, better to go to the house of mourning than to go to the house of rejoicing. Today we have heard a lot about Jackie. How she lived her dash, though short, yet full of experiences and things that people can continue to say about her till tomorrow morning, and we'll be sitting here listening to Jackie's great dash. But I challenge all of us, let us continue to love one another. Let us remove the things that divide us. We really have no time to be angry at each other, and let us find ways to continue to be the strong Ghanaian community that we are. Come out and be a part of this community in lifting each other up. Let's do that for Jackie. And for Nigel, this community is your community. And we are yet to sit down as leaders to think about how we can provide the type of sustenance. I know family is there, but we will need to do something in this community. Leaders who are here, I challenge all of you. We need to put together a scholarship fund for this young man. And we need to meet and begin to plan that, and we need to plan it now. God bless you.
There was a couple of hospitals that Jackie was able to speak to their, you know, work in, and also speak to the staff. We want to give them an opportunity to come and speak if they want to, real quick, at the Methodist, Mansfield, or the Bedford Hospital. Is there anyone here that would like to do that just briefly?
Good afternoon or morning, whatever it is. I don't know where we are. My name is David Impue. I'm one of the Methodist Dallas employees. I work there as a chaplain. I worked very close with Jackie, and most of the times we talked a little bit about our motherland. We talked a little bit about work that we do with people. She happened to be a social worker, and I happened to be a chaplain. So most of the times, we are together. And on that fatal Saturday, I was off. And when I was called to work, I jumped up to the floor. I didn't know who was affected, because I knew both of the staff members, because those were my areas of service. And when I heard it was Jackie and Annette, I had to take a break for myself, because I knew them closely. I knew Jackie's son before I met him. I knew a little bit about Jackie's family, because every time we met, we talked like an Africans do. the pastor said, I am because we are. Those are the words of Professor Bitty. Because you are, therefore I am. And though that philosophy lives in us, and we live it to the Jackie, even at work. We loved Jackie, committed, hardworking, and did everything she did with perfection. She would be missed among our community. And every day, we think about Jackie. Our prayers to the family, our condolences to our friends from Ghana who will learn how to live with a vacuum in their family. May God bless you. May God give you peace. And may God walk with you as you struggle making the adjustment. Our prayers and heartfelt condolences to you. God bless.
Hello, everybody. My name is Blessing, and I'm from Methodist Dallas, Foshinko Town, which is postpartum. That's where the shooting took place. I really don't know how to begin, but I'm just here to tell Jackie that everything she did for her patients, we are really appreciated. It's really sad that we're standing here for this purpose, but God knows the best. I worked night shift, so I wasn't there when it happened. But we were all affected by what happened. Even till today, we've not yet recovered. We're still grieving for losing two of our beloved families. But when we look through what they did, how they changed lives, and how dedicated they were to their job, you know, to their patients, it kind of gives us hope to keep moving. So Jackie, thank you for your work. Thank you for being you, for changing lives. And I also want to say thank you to the family for having such a beautiful lady that changed, you know, people's life. I'm sorry, Mom, for your loss. I'm sorry, guys, for all your loss. And I'm also sorry for our Methodist family, because we, you know, lost our own too. I know our lives will never be the same, but I just want you all to, you know, I don't say don't grieve, because I'm grieving too. We are all grieving. But when you grieve, just remember that God knows the best. And this is a journey that we all will, you know, go through one day. We are here for a purpose. We are here to do our things, you know. God even knows us before we were born. So when we grieve, let's kind of pause and remember the life that she lived, how she made a lot of differences in people's lives. Maybe that will give us the courage, the encouragement and the peace to know that God will happen. Major, I'm so sorry, you know, that I have to meet you like this. But just know your mom was a nice person, okay? And your mom will watch over you, you know, from now on. Just know that you have the angel that, you know, how is, you know, it's well spread. So she's going to be watching over you. And please make your mom proud, okay, by being a good boy you always are, okay? And thank you, everybody. Thank you.
I'm a social worker and a part of the case management department at Methodist Dallas. I had the privilege and the honor of working alongside Jackie. I know a lot of my coworkers are here. Since October 22nd, there has been a big, big void in our department. I remember getting phone calls from Jackie every Monday morning, or emails telling me about the patients that she's helped and provided resources for over the weekend. And I won't ever forget her gossip about her encounters with, oh, you'll never believe these crazy mamas, and I would never do that. And she just always believed that there was good in people regardless of their circumstances. There's this candle on the fourth floor that shines in a plant, and it's a peace lily. And the other day I walked past the peace lily and it was blooming so beautifully. And you can just feel the warmth because Jackie's presence is there. And all the lives that she's touched, I'll never forget. And every time she would call either myself or any of the other case managers asking for their cookie, because she was a lover of sweets, except for candy. She did not like candy, but sweets, she was there. And my heart goes out to the family and to Nigel. We are so sorry for your loss, and know that the case management department, we love Jackie and we will never forget her, and we are here for you guys. And Jackie, just know that we love you and we miss you so much. But you are a big, firm believer of God and his plans, and we do not doubt the plans that he has. And just know your memory will live forever with us. Thank you.
Good afternoon. We are actually not from the hospital. We're from Nigel's school. We are his teachers. So we just wanted to take a quick moment to read something that was written, just because she was an amazing mother. Gosh, if we could have a mother like her for every one of our students, it would be amazing. But please, real quickly, it wouldn't be fair to mention how amazing of a mother she was to her son that she raised as a single mom. Not just any son, but a son that excels, cares about others deeply, and took the time to check on us as teachers and help teachers and other students. If we ever needed anything, she provided that for us. Whether it be paper or pens or anything, she never wanted it to come out of our pocket, so she would provide that so we could help her child, but every child, not just hers. She may have worked a lot as a social worker, hours are long, but she never missed a beat when it came to being an incredible mother. She loved him so deeply and was kind to all school staff that ever encountered her in parent conferences, student council meetings, after school pickups. She was not only a mom that provided, but she was a mom that was on another level to care about the school staff with her words that she provided for us. When teachers needed supplies and always thanked us for loving her beautiful child. Nigel's destined to do amazing things, just like his mother did. And we are proud to say that we were able to have him as a student. We are his fifth grade teachers, so we knew him for a little over a year now. Ms. Durrani is now his sixth grade teacher. Nigel, you're so important to us, and we are here for you. You, my son, are gonna do amazing things. And we know that of you. So your mom is so proud of you, and she will always be with you. Thank you for allowing us a moment just to say.
My goodness, what an impact. What an impact. I'll tell you, you know, the one thing, I'm sitting there listening to all of you, and I was thinking, what kind of impact am I making in this world, right? So I think we can all reflect on our own lives and think about the impact that Jacqueline had on so many lives. And we could have gone for days and days, I think, right? But I'm so grateful for these testimonies. I know you guys are too, but I'm grateful for Crossroads, for us to be able to have you here today so we can honor her life. And as we kind of wrap up today, I want to just make a couple of quick announcements, and I'm going to end with the scripture, and then I'll dismiss you guys. But as we close, we're going to escort the family in just a few minutes over to our grand hall, which I just wanted to kind of end with 2 Timothy 4. This is where Paul says, I've run the race kind of thing, right? And I just want you, as I'm saying these words, I want you to put Jackie's name in those. Okay, so here we go. I, Jackie, have fought the good fight. I've finished the race, and I've kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. And I just want to encourage every one of you, the life that we've celebrated today, let's make our life impact people in those ways, okay? If you need to change something, okay? It's up to us. We don't need to wait for anybody. Does that make sense? So anyway, I want to encourage you today. Thank you so much again for this time. Family, I am so grateful. We love you so much. And we'll be praying for you. So let's pray. We'll wrap this up with a prayer. The funeral service will come up here and escort the family out along with the casket. So, all right, let's pray. Father, we love you. We thank you again for this opportunity to just share Jackie's life with each other. God, thank you that you are a God that loves each one of us. And Father, we are thankful for Jesus, for the sacrifice that he made on this cross, so we can one day spend eternity with you and Jackie. We know that she is there right this minute in your loving arms. And God, one of these days, we know that we will see her again. And we are grateful for that hope, the hope that we have in Jesus. I pray for this comfort for this family, that the comfort only you can give them, God, that goes deep in their hearts. I just pray for that comfort. And I just pray for everyone in this room right now that you would comfort them. Thank you for all you do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Some fools, yeah.